Okay, good evening. I think by now we should be able to take a design and be able to do it. It shouldn't be anything difficult. Once you understand how the layer panels work, then you don't have any problem at all. You will not have any problem at all. So, it's just some few things that we'll probably be looking at. I'm also thinking of not going to do the class all the time. I'll do it once in a week. And if there's a need that I see something that I think I should teach, I will do a video and put it on the YouTube so you guys can watch it from that end. Okay. So last week, I think we looked at the freepix.com where I say you can get your files. Gina, did we open Illustrator? But do you have it now? Okay, but do you? Okay. Okay, so but we did the Photoshop one. Okay, so it's going to be the same thing. Let me look for a file and download. Is somebody talking? The microphone off. Okay. Davido, can you hear me? Can you all hear me? Okay, so let's continue. Okay, so okay. So when you go to Freepik, you can look for anything that you want. So let me just type design. And let me see what will come up. So you can see we have a lot of design. Let me also type flyer. And I mentioned that some are not free, so if you pay for it, then you get it. If not, you will have to just go for the free ones. But there are some that you have to pay for, okay? So let me look for a file that we can probably work on. Okay, so this is green. Let me download it. Re-download. Let me save this photography design. Okay, so let me also look for the social icons. Yeah. I can hear you. What do they say? It shows that downloaded. Downloaded. If it's downloaded, you should come to that now. You see, hey, this file is bigger. Then that's to do with your machine because when you click on the first download, there's another one that there is a second one. You click on it. Do you see that one? It should come. That's what I use every time. On every machine without a problem. No, not necessarily. Yeah, you can just download. Hey, why is my internet slow? This file I'm downloading is big, so let me look for another file. Okay, since it's not loading for me, let me see if I can get a file I have downloaded already. Okay, so when you see the file like this, okay, this one, the EPS, that is the illustrator. So they will give you a sample image of what is it. So let's use this. Yeah, I like this. Let's use this. So for example, I'm coming to do wedding invitation. So I will click on the file, the project file to open it. That is if you download it. Okay, if you download it. Okay, so this is what I was looking for. Okay, so there are a lot of social icons that you can also download for your project. So when you see, you click on the download, you come to attribution required, then you click on free download. Then it should be able to load. Okay, so yeah, so it's good. This one is more so it to download. Illustrator is opening. You can see this, it's opening. Let me look for some Instagram posts. So you type anything you want, you should be able to get. Okay. So Illustrator is loading and then I'm also downloading. Okay, so when you download, you can see, you can look down, you see that the files that are related to it, you have some related ones. Okay, so my Illustrator is open. They are saying that I don't have some of these fonts. Mostly what I do is that I'm not going to teach you how to use Illustrator. I'll teach you how to just use some of the elements. So I don't normally care about the text. But if you want to change the text, you can And so you can see the files are grouped. Okay, so any of them you select, they are grouped. Now what I'll do is that the ones I want, I will select that one and copy. Now it's not all of them that will come in group like this. This is a wedding design, it's a whole set. So that's where they group all of them. But some will come in like just one like this. But what I normally do is that I go to file, new, to create a new workspace and paste it there. Okay. Where I will select a size that is bigger. So normally I select A3. Yeah, so this is A3. I select A3. If you go to print, you get the A3 size. Okay, the portrait will be okay. Then, okay, then I'll paste Control V, or you can go to edit to paste. Now you can see the whole thing is small here. Okay, so as it's selected, I will hold the top there. Now for Illustrator, you have to use Shift Alt. It's not like Photoshop that you use only Alt. So Illustrator, use Shift Alt. Then you drag to expand both sides. Okay. I just want a high resolution image, so that's why I'm doing it like that. Then I'll right click on it to ungroup. They've grouped them. There are a lot of things that have been grouped. But make sure your selection tool is selected. Selection tool is selected before you can do that. Now, when you take this is also grouped. So if I want to delete, I can just pick this and delete. But if you want to change the text, you have to ungroup it. Then you double click on the text. Then you can go in to do the typing, okay? So you can change your text doing this. But I normally don't do it. I wouldn't take you through all those traces. So what I'll do is for you to know how you can remove the background so that you can go and do your own design. So I will remove the text by clicking delete. I will remove this one by selecting it and select delete. So I have this file. Now it has some shadow background. This is it. I don't want the shadow, so I will take the shadow out. Okay, so I have my design like this. With this, I can use it to design the background, my wedding invitation card. So you're going to export it. So when you export it, so I'm going to do a wedding background. Now, see the color model. When I was going to open a new file, I should have done in RGB, but I didn't do it, so it's giving me CRK. So select RGB and then you save it. Okay. Now make sure the resolution is 300 high. Okay. And the quality is also 10. That's the maximum. That is all you need to know to export the file. So you click OK. And so export as JPEG. So there are other formats. So for example, if something I'm exporting and I want it without the background, then I'll use the PNG. Okay. So for example, let me go in for, hey, I didn't even know where I saved the file. Save export as. Okay, it's in design folder. Let me go for another file. Okay, this one. So you need a zip, a WinRAR or any of the zip software to be able to open this. So you can see this. If I want this, I will ungroup it. Okay, so maybe you see this is also grouped. So I will also ungroup that one. You just right click to click on ungroup. So you see that they group this one to inline. Okay, I will also ungroup it. Provided if you want all these three, let me delete this background, delete this. Okay, so they are in line. If this is what I want, I can select this. Okay, see how I'm selecting? I'll just drag on it and then it will select that line. Or you drag on this one and to select, or you just select. And remember, this one you can ungroup it if you want to change something. So see, you see, so you see the F and you see the whole thing. So this one, I'll just pick this like this. Control C or go to edit to copy. Then let me delete this. I'll paste this here. It's small for me, so I'll increase the size using Shift Alt so that I can maintain the aspect ratio. Go to File, Export As. Now this one have to be the PNG because I want it transparent. Okay, so social icons. Please learn to name files. I'm not good with naming all files, so sometimes I'm stranded looking for a file which I should have named. Okay, so it's exporting. So when you come to your folder, you see. So this is the wedding background that we exported. Now I use this to design for somebody. So you see this design. You see that it's different from what we were having there. You see. All these things, we downloaded these icons from the page, the page, and I use it in here. So that's what I used to do this. And initially I used another template to do something like this. Okay, so there are a lot of them there. Now where is the social icon? So this is the social icons. Okay, so it comes without a background. So for example, if I have, let me put this, let me open Photoshop. So that's why I go into Photoshop to do the rest of my thing in Photoshop. That's why I've taken time to show you how to use the Photoshop. Is there any question so far? I'll answer it, then we continue. Hey, how many are you now? Okay, the number has increased. David, you wanted to talk. People are still saying that they can't enter. I'm still surprised. Please, is there any question? Oh, I like my students. They don't ask questions. Okay. Okay, so Photoshop is opening. So this is another background that will work for the wedding thing. Okay, so what I did was just look for wedding. Okay, and they will give me a lot of the design. Okay, Photoshop is open now. I want to see if I can download another background for us to use. Okay, let me go for this. But there are a lot, there are about. You see, they are telling you have 2,000, so you can go through them to see if you can get what you want. Maybe probably you are looking at the colors and those ones. That's why I just look for the background and use my own color in Photoshop for the text. Okay, so let me download this. Please, those of you who refuse to submit the Okay, they say I've reached my limit. So, yeah. I don't know if my subscription expired, but let me check. I think you pay $9 or, yeah, $9 a month. So if it's a business you are doing, you can sign up for it. Every month you pay $9. And because you'll be charging people to get money. So. I use my Facebook to log in. Okay, so let me wait for it to load. I just want to illustrate something. Okay, so let me pick this background. My background refused to load. Maybe it's loading. I am not being patient. Okay, it's actually loading. Okay. So this is the transparent one we did. Something like this. It's transparent. Okay. So I'll use the odds to reduce it. So you see, it's transparent when I exported it as PNG. Look at this lemon. The lemon is also transparent. I think the last time we even look at a design I was working on with the lemon. And look at this fake tree. There's olive tree. Yeah. So you can do all this and do your own arrangements. Okay, so I've signed in, so I can now download. Somebody saying he's not able to enter. The person should try again because I cannot see any lobby here. You are here. Okay. Hey, why are the files today? They are big like this. 43 MB. Okay. I didn't want to use the other file. I wanted to use this one. Gina. Gina. Or Abigail. Yeah, Gina and Abigail, who is married? Who am I is married? Abigail, you are married then. Gina, are you married? You married and did what? You stopped. Hey. Okay, but you had your invitation card, right? Since you stopped, I wanted you to send me invitation card, or you type a name, a date, and time and location. Then we'll do something. Abigail. Abigail. Abigail, can you remember your invitation detail? Or the guys who are here who are married, if you can remember your invitation detail, drop it as a text for me. I'm lazy. I want to copy and paste. So look at it like together with our family, blah blah blah. Or somebody can just drop a name for me. So you can drop your name, this and this. Then we'll humbly request the honor of your presence at your. Yeah, something like that. Unless. Unless you can drop name. You know a lot of ladies. Hey, my file is still downloading. So let's wait for it to download. They say 7 minutes. 7 minutes is it. But if there is any question you can ask. So see this invite too. This one is not bad. Yeah, I'm Andrew, not Andrews. Yeah, that's directly from the Bible. You've been off. Okay. Okay. But there's always a few. But how are you able to enter now? Because it's the same link. I haven't even changed the link. Okay. But why were you not? You should have been watching the video on YouTube. Okay. I get it. Illustrator, we just even start. No, the purpose is that I'm not teaching Illustrator. The purpose of Illustrator is to teach you how to go and download free element on this site, freepix.com. So I'm teaching how you can extract and delete the information on it and use the background or any other thing. You see, there are a lot of elements here you will need for your design. So let me. So you just how I'm teaching you how to you can go and export it and use it in Photoshop. You get it? A file. Yes, because they've done it in Illustrator. So you use the Illustrator to export it. Remove the text on it and then you can. But most of them, I don't use it blindly. I have to. Yes. Okay, so. You export it as a JPEG or PNG file. If it has a transparent background, then you make sure you save it as PNG. So what I was saying is that when you come here, you can just select. Let me go back. Okay. So this file is having a background. I don't even need the background. I just need this particular one. But it looks like they haven't even grouped them. So I will just select the background, that background, delete it. So I'm deleting these ones. If I need this design, I will pick it. Okay, but I'm interested in this one for now. So I will select this one and copy. So you just drag your mouse to cover it, then to select it, then you copy. I told you go to file, new, to open a new document and paste it there, because sometimes the files that comes, the size is small. So we'll select A3 and paste it and enlarge it, so that when you export it, you have the quality. Okay, so, oh, I should have shown you. I think I'm still in the. Okay, let me close it and do it again. So you go to file, new. So you select A3. Then you come to more settings. Okay. So this is the A3, blah, blah, blah. And the color mode, I want it RGB. Don't use the CMYK. So you create document and it will open for you. Then I'll paste what I copied here. Okay, so this is even big enough. It's okay. Then I'll select the text and delete it. So yeah, this is what I want. Then go to file, export, export as. And this at time it will be not, it won't be PNG, it will be JPEG. Okay, so I'll do it word one. That's how easy I type my thing. You can see some of that do is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 by 8, you know. But please, you learn how to name the file correctly. So you have the quality 10, the resolution is 300, so that's all you need, RGB. Then you click OK. And then you see down here that it's exported. Okay, I'm sure it has exported now. So let me go into Word 2. Okay, this is it. Yeah, so this is it. So I'll pick it and put it. Is somebody sending me the invitation? Please, did somebody send an invitation to the page? No, that one is for somebody. I don't want to use it. The person's engagement is not yet out. Okay. So Gina, will you give me any? Gina, will you give me any? Me, I want to copy and paste too. Okay, so there's a white background around it. It means we didn't delete it. I don't need it. You can crop it later. So you select the crop. You can take out the crop size, the 5 by 7. When you take it out, what it will do is that it will maintain the resolution and all that. So then you can go in direct. Okay. But if you have the size, then it will want to take the size, and if it doesn't conform. But if you know the size of your document, you can resize it to fit in. Alex, are you here? Okay, so since you people want to give me work, I'll type. Okay. And remember, it's wedding, so everything has to be stylish. Okay, so I will double click on the T to go and change the font. To what? Let me see if I have respective. I tend to know the name of the files of it, the font. So I'll try. If it's not what I want, then I'll change it. Okay, but wedding invitation have to be stylish. Let me use the signature. Okay, I'm using the brother side signature. So when you go to Google, you can download them. Okay. So I okay. So together with our family, that one is good because I wanted it to come out. So I'll change the font, okay? I'll just use Times New Roman. I'll make it bold. So together with our family. So nobody has given me a name. I don't want to give a name and be in trouble. Ayo. Let me. You know how to use what? Why somebody type any? Prince. You've given a name and you've given a name of the guy. You didn't give the name of the lady. Okay, I'll use a font. I don't know which font I'll use, but let me. Okay. Prince, give the name of your lady. Okay. Now, this test. For lazy people like us, what I do is I just duplicate it by dragging it to the new layer. You see that down there in the new layer. Or you put it on it to duplicate it. Okay. Then, because I wanted to do the at the end, yeah. Then I can duplicate the prints again. Come down, double click on it. Please, who is giving me a name of a woman? Who is giving a woman for? Pearl. Alex, who is Pearl? Pearl Owusu, wherever you are, your name has been mentioned. Okay. So, I'll change the color, which we have done already. Gina, your microphone is on. Or is Alice? Frederick. Frederick, you're this thing. I'll mute you for now. Can't you see I'm working? Okay, I taught you the last time how to pick the color. So you can pick the color using the drop tool. Okay. So what do we need next? The pearl is too down. Let me let them go closer. Yeah, and should be at the middle. So what other thing will come? Is it the date? I'm sure. Okay, so humbly request. Okay. Which line is it in which line? I'm not getting it. You can't hear me. Ah, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Please, the rest, can you hear me? The rest, Gina, can you hear me? Okay. What was the question? Okay, I didn't get the question in itself. Gina was asking a question. Okay. You can go ahead. Yeah, you can go ahead and ask. Can you hear me now? Okay. Hey, did somebody mute me? Or I mute myself? Anyway. Okay, so when I did humbly request your presence at our wedding, I didn't bring the name. Those things it has passed. Unless you want to go and print, then you can do the Mr. and Mrs. But these days you don't really have to invite people, they will come. Everybody is coming to eat, so they will come. So yeah. Now there is a when I did the enter for it to fall on the there's a okay, so if you think the space here is too much, you can just control A to select everything. Come to where the A is, the character. If you can't see the character here, you come to Windows. You see it here, character. Okay, when you select it, you come. So that is the height of the file, this one. So I will use 72 to push it in. It's still up. Okay, so this will help you. You can just drag to increase it or decrease it, it will close up the space. Yeah, and this is the font, the size of the font. Okay, if you want to increase that, the size of the font. So I will probably put the date. So, and the dates, we normally do the date bold sometimes. Okay, 26th November. But mostly people prefer that you write Saturday. So people prefer that you write Saturday. Then you do. So let me make this bold. Then you do add, and then RSVP will come in. So that's how it is done. I'm going to send you this file, and then you can you'll do an invitation and send to me. Or better still, let me send you guys the link. If I send you the background, it's like I'm feeding you. So no, just go. Okay, I'll not send you the background. Go and download any background that you want. Okay. Any background that you want, use it to do an invitation and send it to me. I'll be waiting for it. So let me. Yes, come. Okay, for example, you are dragging this. Is that it? Is this snap to grid? Snap to grid or line? Line to grid. Okay. Photoshop, I have not seen. You want it in the middle. No, I do you see auto select? Is it auto select deselected? It should deactivate the auto select. Apart from that, the top here, auto select. Apart from that, I haven't had any experience because even if it's center, you want to center, you go to view, you can even show ruler to reposition the middle of your, and then you can. The ruler is just to help you to align and those things. But I know there is also snap. The snap will realign with the line. But mostly we use that in 3D. So I've not seen that in Photoshop. Somebody was also going to ask a question. Okay. So please go and look for a background, a wedding background, and send me an invitation. Okay, look at. Oh, do I know? Let me see. I think this one is what humbly request is RetroMark script. Okay. Then the wedding invitation was, what was the name? Brother side signature. If I'll check if I have it, I'll drop it for the page. Okay. So you are doing. Okay. Yes, I mentioned it. I mentioned it earlier that when you are looking out for the design, they all have their color. So, and the person have color, so you have to look at the color of the person. Even this illustrator, if you pick the thing one by one, you can, if you know how to use it very well, you can manipulate the colors. Okay, so if this background, let me see if I, okay, let me pick this. Now, some of them, when you right click, you can't see a group. So you double click again. You see, when I double click, you see that I can now select the flower out of the background. So this thing was designed, everything was designed from scratch. So you can select, I'm trying to look for the background. Now, this is the background color. So you click on it, you see the fill. Then you can, so if this is the color theme of the person, then you're going to select by this color here. So This flower, you can ungroup this flower too. You see? Then you can pick, you see? So I pick only this one. So if I don't need this, I can take this one and leave in this one. Or if that's the only one I want, I can delete these ones. You get it? Then you can reposition or you can export this alone to go and use it on a different background for a different design. This one, when you right-click on it, you can still ungroup it. Somebody spent his time to design this. So you can see the parts that comes together to make the flower. So when you see them, it's not like it's just a background. You can dismantle the whole background. So if I want this, I can copy this. But it's very important that you look out for the color, the theme that the couple they are using. And then you use it to do the. But remember, every design there is going to be white inside it. I mean, because of the wedding. Well, they normally white use white a lot. So let me delete this. Then I paste this. Okay. I will ungroup it to remove these small ones around it. These ones. So this one I will just drag to select them. I don't want it, but if you want it, you can go for them. Once you drag in the line touch any of them, they will delete. They will be selected and then you can delete it. Okay, you. So this one will be PNG because I wanted it transparent. Okay, so for example, let me go and draw. Let me open a new workspace. So the design that there are many there. There are many. You can even type just invitation. So 5 by 7. Okay, so if I do this background, like I just use rectangle, I draw rectangle. So then I'll go and look for. So I'll resize it. It's too big there. Okay. Then I'll duplicate it by dragging it to the new layer here. Or you can right click on it and you'll see where is duplicate layer. Then you duplicate it. Okay. Now see what I'm got. So I send it down here, but I want it to face the top like this. I'm showing you what to do. You go to edit, free the transform. Okay, so it's vertical, so I'll do it vertical. So yeah. I'll do it vertical. Okay. My light is off. My light is off, so I will end today, then decide on the time that we'll meet again. Bye bye.